community media from public, city, and county government access channels. You'll notice the Roman columns and floral arrangements. We've combined the neoclassical with the postmodern, and I have a remote control here. With the help of this miniature satellite transceiver tuner, you'll see excerpts from some of very dynamic programming, and you'll get to meet the producers as well and get a few surprises along the way. And speaking of very special surprises, please welcome my co-conspirator and hostess of tonight's festivities, Christina Bowden.
Thank you, Dr. Doug, and welcome everyone.
Christina, would you introduce our first guest who joins us via videotape?
Excuse me. Certainly, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the Honorable Dick Greco, Mayor of Tampa.
I'm sorry I couldn't be with you.
Recognize the outstanding programming achievements on public educational and government access television. I would like to pay tribute to everyone who has volunteered their time and talent for public educational and government access television in Tampa and Hillsborough County. Freedom of speech is among the most cherished freedoms in our nation, and access channels preserve this right. The public educational and government access channels keep our citizens informed in ways that didn't exist 20 years ago when I was first mayor of the city of Tampa. I encourage everyone to become familiar with the PEG access channels by watching and participating in access programs. Thank you again for your contribution, and enjoy the evening.
I've been asked to read this proclamation from Dick Greco. It's kind of long and involved, so bear with me, please. Whereas freedom of speech is among the most cherished freedoms in our nation and the world, and whereas each generation must protect and defend the freedom it cherishes, whereas the individual is guaranteed the freedom to speak to the community, and, on occasion, needs a platform from which to speak freely. And, whereas public access enables citizens to communicate through the medium of television, and whereas government access serves the principle of government in the sunshine through the medium of television, and whereas educational access facilitates communication between the educational institutions of Hillsborough County and the people they serve. Now, therefore, I, Dick A. Greco, by virtue of the authority vested in me as mayor of the city of Tampa, Florida, do hereby proclaim Wednesday, June 14th, 1995 as Cable Access Day. In the city of Tampa, Florida, and encourage all citizens of our community to become familiar with public, education, and government access channels by watching the programs and responding to the issues raised, and by participating in the production of programs. And it's dated the 14th of June, 1995 by Dick Greco. Thank you so much, the Honorable Dick Greco, for a wonderful boon to cable access.
Oh, thank you, Christina, and thank you, Mr. Mayor. And now, ladies and gentlemen, before we rev up the engines for tonight's program to take off power, we need to thank the volunteers who will lead us this evening into a renaissance of access programming. I'm talking, of course, about the public access producers who donated their time, their energy, and creativity to help make tonight's show possible. How about a big round of applause for the crew of tonight's show, as well as the finalists who contributed groundbreaking programming. Well, what do you say, Christina? Are we about ready to rock?
Ready to rock and roll. Dr. Doug, in the immortal words of someone from California, or at least a movie about someone from California, not even. We haven't discussed the rules or judging criteria. A pretty glaring omission, wouldn't you say?
It is pretty glaring. It is pretty glaring, I must admit that. Let me put on my sunglasses. I don't know what I was thinking. Go ahead.
Even they surprised me, even. Yes. Let's see if we can log on to this.
Satellite feed.
The satellite feed from the Institute for Research and Analysis of the Causes and Effects in and of Fine TV Program. Our resident legal analyst is standing by.
Of course she is. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Institute's own in-house counsel, the honorable and lovely, talented as well, Greta Van Allenbelt. Greta, can you hear us? Can you feel us near you?
Yes, Dr. Doug. The satellite feed is functioning flawlessly.
Greta, because you are an eminent legal scholar and well-known TV personality because of your commentary on the sensational H.J. Simpson murder trial, we'll ask you to read the rules and criteria for programs considered for the 1995 Golden Cassette.
Certainly, Doctor. Programs being submitted for the 1995 Golden Cassette Video Awards must have had their first telecast on a public, educational, or government access channel between January 1st, 1994 and January 1st, 1995. Among other qualities, the finalists and winners will demonstrate a commitment to excellence and thoroughness in producing programming of genuine interest and concern to the community. Judging criteria includes not only technical and aesthetic qualities, such as camera work, picture composition, editing, and graphics, but also the program's approach to developing and maintaining viewer interest, the uniqueness and creativity of the producer's treatment of subject matter, and the extent to which the programming challenges the conventional commercial television format.
Greta, just a few questions before the satellite feed cuts off. How did the DNA evidence affect the judging process?
Not at all, as far as I can tell. But of course, we must remember that H.J. Simpson's blood was never found in any of the studios or edit suites that the DA's office did their RFLP testing. It's going to be very interesting to see how the determining factor of the Golden Cassette judges will differ from those of Judge Nito.
Judge Nito, yes. Well, thank you, Greta. We're on pins and needles ourselves, and we'll beam you the results on your favorite satellite network as they become available. Thank you, Greta. And while we're giving thanks, let's honor the people who gave their time and thought to judge the entries. Doug?
On behalf of all entrants, we offer hearty thanks to our judges. Dr. Randy Miller, the USF Mass Communications Department.
Dan Traggett, University of Tampa Communication Department.
Betty McBride, licensed mental health counselor.
Jeff Arnwine, THC Cable Advisory Committee.
Karen Bishop, TGH Psychiatric Center.
Rob LeRae, News Director, WMNF Community Radio.
Wes Crowell, Jones Inner Cable.
Nancy Vaughn.
Beth Dorsey.
Julie Dumois, TGH Psychiatric Center.
Richard Sands, my man.
Rex Hall, Channel 66's man.
Craig Johnson, Hillsborough Community College.
Jan Rosicki.
Dr. Larry Leslie, USF Mass Communications Department.
Bill Greco, Hillsborough Community College.
James Welch, Wizard Works Incorporated.
Jim Roth, Tampa AIDS Network.
Shirley Rose, Lotto winner.
Susie Martini, student, Hillsborough Community College.
Janet Montgomery, Vaughn Communications.
Glenn Nunn, Prepaid Legal Services.
Well, I think it's about time we can start handing out some awards. Let's see.
Yeah, let's see indeed. Actually, Dr. Doug, I was wondering about the judging process. I mean, you know, we know the criteria, but how were the results tabulated, the numbers crunched, the data processed?
Valid questions indeed, Christina. You know, an old colleague of mine at the Institute might be better qualified. Let's see if we can bring him in on the Golden Cassette Satellite. Come in.
Dr. Doug, is that the host of Wine and Cheese, my favorite public access show you're there with?
Oh, I can't tell a lie. Christina.
Oh, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you one of our network's chief actuarial analysis engineers to explain the dynamics of the scoring process. Please welcome via satellite,
well,
Dr.
Certainly,
Mobius Stripp.
Dr. Doug, the scoring of the 1995 Golden Cassette Video Awards was a very sophisticated process. It started with the judges viewing videotape entries such as this one right here and recording their findings on judges' score sheets, such as the one here shown behind me. The score sheets were then gathered together and the information was punched onto hollerith cards, which were then fed manually into the UNIAC model several thousand memory translator device. This device, which computes in one day what it would take a mere human 24 hours, the winners and finalists for tonight's categories. In the event of a tie, the ordinal numbers are removed and replaced with the cardinal values from the score sheets, and the judge's overview was removed, thus determining the winner.
Oh, so it's like the Olympics, huh?
Yeah, like the Olympics.
Wow, Doctor, I must say you've provided us with new insight into the television world.
Yeah, very thrilled, yeah.
Yeah, likewise, I'm sure. It's great to see you again, and thanks a lot for your help. All right, Christina, let's get to it. How about introducing our first category and guest presenter for this evening?
Certainly, Dr. Doug, it'll be my pleasure. Our first category is news and information. Will you all help me welcome our first guest presenter, Jones Intercable General Manager Irene Picard.
Thank you. The 1995 Golden Cassette Video Award for Best News and Information Programming honors excellence in reporting on events or issues important to the viewing audience. Finalists for the News and Information Single Program category are Montage Cable News, producer Georgette Reinhardt. Wine and Cheese, producer Frank Bernhardt. And the winner is Wine and Cheese, produced by Frank Bernhardt.
Thank you so much. I don't look like Frank, but I was the host of the show, and we had a great season.
As you know, wine is spelled W-H-I-N-E, which means we whine about a different topic each week. This week, you can be the proud owner of this Vendage Merlot, the wonderful year of 1993, if you call in and whine about what you see on television. Tonight, we have local TV journalist Yolanda Fernandez, and later Paul Wilborn from the St. Pete Times and Lindsay Peterson from...
Oh, thank you so much. That was a show about local journalists, and the concept of wine and cheese is one in which people from the community are allowed to call in and whine about the topics that we present. And if they whine well or they have a cheesy comment, since it is a live show, they get prizes. And basically, the idea is to involve the community in topics of interest, everything from transvestites to workaholics to underachievers, kids who stay home all day and don't have to work. So we look forward to more seasons of Wine and Cheese. Frank Bernhardt is not out of the country, but out of the state, so I'm happy to accept this award for him. Thank you so much.
Finalists in the News and Information Series category are Focus, producer Shirley Gregory. Montage Cable News, producer Georgette Reinhardt. Personality Profile, producer Anita Skinner. And the winner is... Always wanted to say that. Personality Profile, produced by Anita Skinner.
Well, I've been affiliated with the fire service since 1977. In 1981, I went to school and took five courses, one week each, and I became certified with the state of Florida as a fire inspector.
And you don't have to become a fireman first?
No. That's a common misconception.
Yes, it is, because I always thought a fire inspector had to be a fireman first, and then he got Alice.
I need to come on out here and get your award.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you for everyone that worked on my productions. Without them, I could never receive anything like this. So I want to thank everybody that worked on Personality Profile. Some helped me a lot more than others, but if they all helped me, especially Judy Hawley and Bill Ellert, Myra Forrester, a whole bunch of people. So thank you very much.
Thanks to Ms. Picard and Jones Intercable for their contributions to tonight's event. I'd like to add, if I could, that exactly what Anita just said. So many people volunteer their time to help all of us do the shows that we do. And there's no way that we could do it. They stay long hours. They don't really get any glory. And we really, 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 really appreciate all your help. And I'd encourage anybody interested in video come on down and help out too. There's free food sometimes. Just thought I'd mention that.
That's what brought me down here.
And now for our next category, Best Municipal Program. We are extremely honored to welcome our next guest presenter, City Councilman Bob Buckhorn, District 3 at large.
Thank you. The award for Best Municipal Program honors the efforts of government access producers to inform viewers about municipal issues in a more in-depth fashion than would be possible in a commercial news broadcast format. The finalists in this category are Behind the Scenes at TPD, producers Tom D. and Steve Cole. Spotlight, the K-9 Unit, producer Steve McClure. And the winner is Spotlight, K-9 Unit, produced by Steve McClure.
German Shepherds are the most commonly used breed of dog because they are naturally adept at police work and are familiar to the public as law enforcement dogs. Before a canine can be commissioned to serve the sheriff's office, they must first undergo several weeks of extensive training.
During our 16-week training course, which is a basic foundation for their patrol work, we teach them their obedience. They have to do voice and hand.
This canine show was just one in a series that I've been producing, highlighting the Hillsborough County Sheriff's Office. I'd like to thank God for giving me the ability to produce this show, and secondly, for Sergeant Rod Reeder from the Sheriff's Office for volunteering his time to both host and narrate. You know, I thought with the popularity of TV cop shows right now, Spotlight had potential for being a hit, and it's been very well received. Thank you.
Congratulations, Steve, and thanks to Councilman Buckhorn.
Doug, I see the entertainment category is next. Who's our next presenter?
Christina, our next guest presenter, is sure to bring back some fond TV memories for some of those baby boomers in our audience, who probably remember him as the mischievous, impish little bundle of energy in everyone's favorite 50s sitcom, Daddy's Little Delinquent. He is also the author of a scathing expose of the Hollywood child actor stage mother syndrome. I'm sure you've all read his book, Oedipus Takes Gomorrah, soon to be a made-for-TV movie. Please welcome everyone's favorite embittered has-been child actor, J. Edgar Dillinger.
Dr. Doug, Christina, like your hair, babe. All right, when we honor entertainment, we must also consider the anguish, the sacrifices, the pain, the lost youth. The ugliness behind the scenes, because you see, television is itself a petty illusion. Offered up by charlatans and who care nothing about...
Actually, Mr. Dillinger, if we could maybe move along, I think the question we'd all like answered is...
You want answers?
Yes, I think we're entitled to some answers.
Yeah, you want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
The envelopes, the awards, please.
No, it's that. Oh, I got them, huh, babe? No, okay.
The finalists for entertainment single programs are Dirty Soap, producer Jim Morse, yay. The Jim Nolan Show, producer Jim Nolan. And Story Mount, producer Glenn Plock. And the award goes to Storybound, producer Glenn Plock.
We had a lot of problems go wrong with it. I'd like to thank Jones Intercable for giving me a lot of help, the liaisons down there. I'd like to thank Mark Alexander and Kay Campbell for believing in what I do. I'd like to thank Jim Moss especially and John Magliano for helping me finish that production. Thank you.
Well, gee whiz, Jay, are you going to be okay for the series category, or would you perhaps like some medication of some kind?
Do I look okay? Okay.
Should we answer that?
Give it a shot.
Like now, the socks, babe.
Oh, thank you, doll. Okay, now, I don't have a list of the nominees with me here. Can you do the honors?
I will, Jay. The finalists for the entertainment series are Focus, producer Shirley Gregory. And very well, very good. Shirley. And Virtual Television, producer Brinson M. Harris.
Yay. Yay. Okay, the award goes to Virtual Television, producer Brinson M. Harris.
Yay. Here he comes.
This is great. Mr. Brinson can't be... Oh, here he is.
There's Mr. Boucho. And I believe in actuality, the show is on right now. You wouldn't mind if we played through, Mr. Mojo, would you?
Dr. Mojo, and we're kind of on the air, so I'd really like it if, you know, maybe you could take the tour group and maybe leave.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mojo is using irony and sarcasm. What he really means is he'd love for you all, New Access producers, to come down and ask him some questions about his show and experience one of the most advanced multimedia presentations known to mankind.
After an introduction like that. Well, that's Virtual Television, folks. I'd like to thank the people that watched the show and the people that called into it and enjoyed it. Enjoyed bringing it to you. I've had a few inquiries about bringing it back. And I think Virtual Television as a series is a done deal. But not to worry, because Virtual Television is now the name of my production company, and I'm going to concentrate on making virtual movies. And I hope to have one playing in this theater before the end of the century. I hope you all come out and see it. Thank you very much.
If anyone can do it, you can do it, Brinson. Thank you. That is definitely entertainment, folks. Let's shift gears now and welcome our next guest presenters for the public affairs category.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the cable administrator for the city of Tampa, John McGrath, and Hillsborough County cable administrator, Frank Toronto.
Cable access channels provide the community with commercial-free airtime, allowing for detailed coverage of public affairs without sensationalism or advertisement. The award for Best Public Affairs Programming honors thoroughness, objectivity, and genuine concern for the community.
Would you? I want you to stand on that side. I need some protection if you don't mind. Last year, John, we followed two clowns. This year, we follow a guy with an accent I never heard before. The finalists for the Best Public Affairs Single Programs are AIDS, Another Way Drugs Can Kill, producer Barbara Holbrook. Community Affairs Report, producer Margarita Gonzalez Lampui. And HIV, HIV and You, producer Joel Provost. And the award goes to Community Affairs Report, produced by Margarita Gonzalez Lampui.
Let me welcome our guest for the day, Yolanda Fernandez. Hi, Yolanda.
Thank you, Maggie. Hello.
Hi. You're a reporter, anchor, many, many other functions I imagine you do with Channel 8 locally here in Tampa. But before that, I'd like to know you a little bit better. Tell us a little bit about where you grew up and how did you end up in...
Thank you so much. I wish you would have had an opportunity to see some of the roll-ins that we have for that program. It was a very special program to us because that featured the Cuban situation, and I think we felt very proud not only to have someone of the caliber of Yolanda Fernandez be our guest, but also to show a very objective view of what the situation in Cuba was at the time the program was taped, showing both the Cuba for Cubans and also the Cuba that is seen by the tourists and the people that have the opportunity to visit the island. I'd like to thank all of the GA TV staff. At that time that we taped the program, also we were teasing and calling it the Gypsy program because we were in the process of getting our new studios built, and we basically went all over town finding a place to host us, and this was actually taped at a room in the Tampa Convention Center. That's why you don't get to see the regular set that we have now. So hopefully you continue to watch Community Affairs Report on Channel 14 and also get to enjoy the other topics that we have to offer. Thanks so much, and this is quite an honor. Thank you.
Margarita Gonzalez Lampui. Okay, I get another kiss for that? I tried that. You've done that, Richard. I don't want to do it again, please. Okay, we have one more award. The finalists for the Best Public Affairs Series are Nonprofit Today. I hope this isn't about the NPO for public access, but... Nonprofit Today, produced by Bruce McDowell. And Our House, produced by Joel Sousa. And the award goes to Our House, produced by Joel Sousa. Accepting for Joel is Fred Meyer, correct? Congratulations.
Plyler, and this is Our House. Our House is a program about housing put on by the Mayor's Challenge Fund Partnership. Today we're going to be talking about the East Tampa Initiative, which I think unquestionably is one of the largest, most comprehensive housing initiatives that the City of Tampa has ever done.
Well, it is a surprise for me to be up here. It's really the wrong side of the camera, wrong side of the spotlights, but... We put a lot of work into the show. Jones Intercable and Government Access, City of Tampa TV, gave us a lot of assistance. We couldn't have done it without them or without our hostess, Harriet Plyler. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you all.
Thank you, gentlemen. We'd like to remind all of you watching and all of you here that if you work for the city or county, a great way to play hooky, if your boss will let you, is come down to Public Access and learn how to produce a video. You could do a single program or a series, and let me think, that could take about 20 out of 40 hours of your week out. So contact Public Access and we'll see you down there. The next category is a personal favorite of mine.
And what would that be, Christina?
Talk show. And here to present the award for Best Talk Show, that's a surprise, is former Public Access producer and now, yes, some people do go somewhere sometimes, thank you, and now producer for WTVT Channel 13, please welcome Rick Rollins.
Thank you, Doug and Christina. The talk show genre in itself is not a new genre. It is not a new activity. It is not unique, nor is it original. But I'm sure that you'll agree that talented producers and a good host can create a unique and original talk show. And the finalists in the talk show single program category are Insights, producer Ben Taylor, Focus on Reality, produced by Joel Provost, and Wine and Cheese, producer Bill Quinnen. And the winner is, I remember right about now, my heart used to be jumping, and I'd be ready to kill somebody if my name wasn't called. The winner is Wine and Cheese, produced by Bill Quinnen.
Once or twice in our lives, but tonight we have some answers for you on that. And with me is Dr. Karen Chamberlain, clinical psychologist practicing in Tampa. Welcome.
Hi.
Hi. You've been in practice for about 18 years?
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
And you said that you deal with a large percentage of people who say they're lonely.
I would say roughly 60.
Wow, we sure were lonely that day, weren't we, Christina?
Very, extremely. Maybe you were. Of course I wasn't.
Well, of course not. Obviously, I would like to thank Christina because she was the host of the show. And the crew was a, I won't say a pickup crew. Sometimes we had steady people. Other times I had to grab someone out of the hallway. But believe it or not, we went on the air, and this was a live program, just like this one is now. So anything can happen, and thank you very much.
My favorite category, the nominees or finalists for talk show series category are personal favorite of mine, personality profile, producer Anita Skinner. Another personal favorite, Solutions with Dean, Dean Holbrook. And the winner is Solutions with Dean, Dean Holbrook.
Alcohol and drugs are an equal opportunity destroyer. Solutions, you're on the air.
Dean.
Yeah.
I just wanted to know, have you ever done drugs yourself?
Yeah. I got 18 years experience drinking and drugging. I've been clean and sober for over 16.
What, I mean, heavy, heavy drugs?
Yeah. You name it, I did it.
Before I say anything, I got to give this man a round of applause myself. Because if it wasn't for Rick Rollins, I never would have started my program. When I first began my program, I was telling you about the 9, 10-year-old and 11-year-olds that are in trouble with alcohol and drugs in their families and in their lives. Those that are 16, 17, 18-year-old, you read about in the paper every single day. Unfortunately,
on June 7th, 1995 at midnight, the program of Solutions died and is no longer being able to be seen out in the county. Mr. Mayor, if you're watching this program tonight, I'm going to call on you personally for your proclamation tonight and help us restore free speech back to the county in Hillsborough. And every one of you city producers sitting here tonight, I have to remind you, you are also county residents. You have a voice to be heard too. And I'll tell you the same thing I've been saying on my show for over 8 years. No matter what the problem is, if you're not a part of the solution, you're a part of the problem.
All right, thanks a lot, Dean, and congratulations. Your show has been a mainstay on the Access Channel, and I know everybody appreciates the hard work and you put into that show, and to Rick Rollins, super suave guy that you are. Thanks for coming down here tonight. Our next category honors excellence in coverage of a community event.
Our cable access channels allow community events to be seen in their entirety without commercial interruption. Please join me in welcoming our next guest presenters, Tampa Hillsborough County Cable Advisory Committee Chairman Jeff Arnwine and committee member and public access producer Richard George.
Richard and I were trying to figure out who was going to go on the left and the right, so since I'm conservative, I thought I'd go on the right. Thanks, Christina. The fast-paced commercial nature of broadcast news usually allows only a brief synopsis of events. Coverage by volunteer community producers allows those unable to attend to see and experience these events for themselves.
The award for best community event coverage goes to the producer who donates his or her time, labor, creativity, and documentation and preservation of community events. The finalists in the best community event coverages are AirFest 94, Bill Quinnen. Focus producer, Shirley Gregory. And the winner is Jeff.
AirFest 94, Bill Quinnen.
Wingtips overlapping, the team flies up and over the top in a maneuver called the Clover Loop.
That is flying, folks. Okay, I'd like to take a look at it. I forgot my list, so I'm trying to do it from memory. Some of the people that were on the crew. Tom Colbert, Judy Holly, Gary Aldrin, of course our engineer James Austin, Jim Nolan and Wayne Melton helped do some of the interviews that I used in the shoot. This is a lot of fun, okay? Believe it or not, obviously we did it live. But you will believe that sometimes the camera people were saying to myself and the director, I can't see anything, okay, which is true because the planes are flying high and fast, okay, but as you notice, we did get it on tape. But as I think I heard Dean say earlier, June 7th was a sad day in Hillsborough County, okay, unless my Irish luck comes back, you will not see AirFest 95. But thank you for the award very much, I appreciate it.
Nice job, Bill. And I just want to say something I've always wanted to say. You're a major stud.
All right.
Congratulations. Doctor, what's next on our agenda?
Our next category is Best Editing, which honors
Best Editing,
of course. And our next presenter should have some keen insights about editing. She's a professor of film and video editing at the Institute of Research and Analysis of the Cause and Effects in and of Fine TV Programming. Will you please welcome Olivia Newton-Stone.
Thank you, Dr. Duck. Editing, perhaps the most important process in crafting a film or video diamond from a celluloid or oxide lump of coal. As time-traveling optometrist Billy Pilgrim once noted, life is a series of randomly strung together moments. But we're not talking about life, are we? We're talking about video, so just forget I said it. In his novel, Animal Farm, British author George Orwell identified the problem of television as the fact that it is a medium for the manipulation of information rather than the propulsion of it. The award for best editing goes to the producer who manipulates images and sounds in the most creative fashion. The finalists for best editing are Dark Assumption, producer Glenn Plaw. Illusions, producer Jason Beisel. Virtual Television, producer Brenson M. Harris. And the winner is Virtual Television, produced by Brenson M. Harris.
Back to the virtual television report on television itself. So you know I'll be objective, right? No, seriously, folks. By the end of this show, we'll know exactly what television is. Technical marvel advancing the cause of mass communication, or just a radioactive piece of furniture drawing idiots like moths to light? Maybe both. Maybe neither. Only the doctor knows for sure. First up, some items from the VTV fact file. Believe it or not, there actually was a time when there was no television. Boggles the mind, huh? So what did people do? Oh, sure, we've heard grandma's stories about...
Well, best editing, you're pretty much locked in the edit suite by yourself, so I guess the people to thank this time would be the Access Center staff, because they have probably the toughest job in television, which is to teach anybody who walks in off the street how to do a TV program. I'd like to thank everybody at the Access Center that helped me learn how to edit, and the way that I knew I was finished with the show was I was sick of looking at it, so I just edit a show till I'm sick of looking at it, and then it's finished. So thank you very much.
Is that the legendary Dr. Doug? I hear you've been jet-setting all over the world with the likes of David Letterman.
That's true. Thank you, Christina. And thanks to Brinson. I've been doing Access cable shows since about 1985, and I've always worked with some really great writers and producers, and I've been the on-air talent. And so it's just nice to know that the legacy will continue. Brinson saw a show that I had done with Ed Favera, and he liked it so much that we collaborated on virtual television. And congratulations to all of Brinson's hard work. It takes a lot of time to put a show of that magnitude together, and it's fun to watch, even though he's tired of watching it.
And it couldn't be done without you, of course.
Oh, thank you, Christina. Well, anyway, enough of that. But I really do appreciate that. The check's in the mail. Now, our next category is Best Director, and our next guest presenter is something of a living legend in the pantheon of feature films. Movie buffs all the world over were thrilled beyond words at last summer's big budget blockbuster Jurassic Shark and the previous summer's hit comedy Honey, I Accidentally Exposed You and the Kids to a Lethal Strain of Germ Warfare Virus. Please join me in welcoming the great C.B. Spielberg.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please contain your applause. I know you all must be simply in awe, but for the sake of all others who follow, save some for them. It is only fitting that I, the world's greatest director, introduce the category for Best Directing and the finalists therein. I'm sure you all recall my bittersweet romantic treatment in this summer's blockbuster hit romantic comedy, My Wife Doesn't Understand Me. And it is a bittersweet reality that all our finalists cannot win. The finalists for Best Directing are Centerfold, Julie Bishop. Design Secrets, Jason Bessel. And Storybound, Glenn Pla. And the winner is Design Secrets, Jason Bessel.
On these carpets, you might have heard the term footprint free, and actually they're not actually footprint free, but they don't show a lot of traffic marks or vacuum cleaner marks. What they've done is they've gone in on the yarns going up the sides of the yarns. They've twisted them very tight or tightly, and what they've done is drawn the yarn down so that you have a denser.
It was really a fun show to work on. I want to thank Linda Lou Harrison, who's not here tonight, everyone at Jones Intercable, and my parents. Thank you.
Thanks, Jason. We're going to miss you. He's on to, of course, bigger and better things in Chi-Town, Chicago, USA. But I want to tell you all how many nights he has labored in the back rooms of Public Access, sponging this, sponging that, making design sets. He's extremely creative. I know you'll go far, but don't leave us.
All right, well, thanks a lot, CB. I see you're a union outfit, and I know this is costing you. It has to be costing you and your investors thousands of dollars every minute while you do the not, I mean, while you stand there. So go ahead and say goodbye to you and your union do-nothing suck-up capital flunkies.
Thank you, Doug, and break a leg or a bodily appendage yourself.
Oh! Thank you, CB. Hooray for Hollywood. Hooray for Tampa Access, actually. Dr. Stone had some interesting observations about life being a series of moments, didn't she?
Actually, that was Kurt Vonnegut's observation, if you might remember, but valid nonetheless. Let's take a look back now at some memorable moments of Golden Cassette's past.
Before there was Jones Intercable, there was only Tampa Cable. Nevertheless, the first Golden Cassettes debuted in 1986 from the luxurious Studio A, and what a debut it was.
The Silver Cassette Award winner for Pinellas County, Frank Serrano, why don't you come on up and accept that award for Pam Levy and those folks.
Well, I'll thank you, Pam Levy, for this, and she did a good job and gives us and people in Hillsborough County something to shoot for now and something for the city of Tampa to shoot for also.
Now let's take a look at some stupid people.
All I can think of to say is,
Thank you.
All right.
When I first came in Access Center, the only thing I knew about television was how to turn it on and watch it.
And now back to you, Les.
Thanks, Ann. 1987 had its own share of budding stars. Even Walt Belcher dropped by to share his feelings on Public Access.
Well, I hope that more and more people in Tampa become aware of public television and public access television and come on down here and make some new programming and watch some of this programming.
and everybody else that had anything to do with it, I want to thank you a lot. This is as much yours as it is mine.
We had a very large crew, but I just made a couple of small notes so that I'd remember everyone.
I don't believe this. This is unreal. I'm very, very happy about this.
My name is Doug Martin, and I want to thank Tampa Access, Jones Center Cable, for allowing us to do our program, Reel to Reel.
Recognize those staff members who do work here every day to help you try to make what it is that you have in your mind come true. I want to start with some of the liaisons.
I'd like to say thank you very much. It was a pleasure to be able to do this with Jones Center Cable.
I don't know what to say. This is the last category I ever expected to win anything in. Quite honestly.
1988 realized a new set, new hosts, and new management.
Welcome to the third annual Golden Cassette Awards. I'm Carol Spring.
And I'm Carol Sudler. We're glad to be here with you. Glad to come to you live. Let's first introduce our keynote speaker, Katho Kempfe.
Produced by real people, not professionals, but people like you who have something to say and are willing to take up the challenge and come in and make their own programs.
It's the viewers that make Hot Seat work, people that call in, the people that participate in a live, interactive television program such as ours.
I'd like to especially give a thanks to Elysian Fields, whose music that was.
It's wonderful. I love community producing. I wouldn't see the community without it.
I'd like to accept this award on behalf of Frankie Faison, who could not be here tonight because of a previous engagement, but I know he's excited to receive it, and thanks you all very much.
And I'd like to thank Ben Taylor and Thomas Mueller, the two most important men, I think, in my life.
Live from DiCaprio Hall, the 1989 Golden Cassettes were influenced heavily by the Twilight Zone.
A lot of people have seen the program and have been able to come to the city and get jobs through this program, so we believe we're providing a very good community service.
It takes more than one person to be able to do anything, so I want to thank everybody.
This is just demonstrative of the kind of creative work that I see coming out of our shop.
I'd like to thank my husband for always being with me and behind me.
Where is Ed Favara? Couldn't make it tonight.
No, that was Doug accepting.
Doug accepting for him. Okay. All right, sorry about that. Animal Friends by Gary Pat.
You don't know what went on, you don't need to know anyway.
David Tavara, come up here. The Golden Animal Friends is given to David Flavius.
I want you to know what David Duke has to say.
I believe you. You sound like an honest man. Let's see.
Gary Platisse, Michelle.
David Springer, who is in the band. So we'll go and deliver that to him right now. Is Dave Springer in here? Dave Springer. Here's your award.
Carol, I don't have time, okay?
And secondly, I'd like to thank my mom and dad, who are watching this evening. Hi, mom and dad. For basically loving me enough and believing in me enough and teaching me how to believe in myself.
1990 moved the awards to the Performing Arts Center. Too bad a spotlight wasn't in the budget.
Freedom of speech is also a motivation at the Public Access Center. I think everyone there believes in freedom of speech.
This is fantastic. We started out in Jones at the Cable studio. We made big time.
Yeah! The great thing about public access is that you can't do it by yourself. I have a very special thank you for Susan Guthrie, Tom D.
About 12 years ago, most of you wouldn't give me the right time of day. Never mind shake my hand and give me an award.
Tampa Theater provided the ambiance for the 1991 awards. The wheels of progress were in motion.
Everybody out there, you're great, and I love you. And I love public access.
I don't know, everybody who's ever given us support in the past, and thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot. Broccoli.
I'd like to thank the crew, but this was a one-man production, so
But the Tampa Amateur Radio Club did put on a great show, and I was just there to take pictures of it.
I'm very happy to be up here. I'm very happy that we have a public access. I thank the Lord that public access is in Tampa, because it has brought me great joy.
Well, I'm very surprised to have received this award, and much more excited and nervous than I thought I would be.
And obvious thanks go to Fifi the Human Poodle.
And to be host of PWW has been great and fulfilling. Thank you very much.
And I just want to give an award to the hardest working 16-year-old in the world.
Thank you very much, and let's hope the county continues to support us.
The 1992 awards were true Hollywood. 3 hours long and hundreds of dollars over budget, one thing was certain. Public access would never be the same.
Let's get this party started.
The club, Mario Hernandez.
Every month we shoot 4 shows, and the energy that these kids have to bring to the camera is amazing.
I got it. I'm sorry. I beat you.
Especially my husband. I said I wasn't going to do this, but you always get nervous. Martin Ortega, who gave me all his support.
First of all, I'd like to thank God for my body.
I'd like to thank my wife, Davika, sitting over there with helping me get through it. There's a name wrong on here.
I want to thank Jones Intercable for giving me the opportunity to share my knowledge of self-love and understanding with everyone through my message of learning, growing, and changing.
And here are the nominees. No, this is the winner.
I'm so excited. I want to thank Jones Intercable. They're the best.
That girl needs to cheer up a little bit, don't you think?
I'm gonna cry.
We are blessed to have Jones Intercable and also the other cable companies that do transmit the cable signals throughout Hillsborough County.
1993 ushered in the techno dance party era. Flying cameras were only the beginning of a magical night.
Making a Difference by Amy Siebert and Carrier.
This show really is not Amy Siebert Carrier. It belongs to the Hillsborough Association of Volunteer Coordination.
Dario, as always, is working very hard in the van, so he couldn't accept the award himself. He'd like to thank Pam Webb and Jerry Mead.
Paper Forest, Glenn Flair.
The underlying theme of the Paper Forest was that all of us in our own special way can help save the environment.
The second attempt, I came second. The third attempt, I got it.
And the winner is Who Shall Call Him King of Kings? Gerald Mead. Mr. Mead is on camera and can't step away from his duties to accept this.
But I cannot be there in the flesh. That is why we have this satellite link to the ceremony hall. And I must say, there are some fine looking women out there.
I'm really thankful for what public access has to offer us and how much time and money is spent to give us the privilege to do shows and get on the airwaves and make a fool of ourselves sometimes.
I know public access is free speech, but it doesn't say just to throw a camera on and go. So I hope to God that we work hard at it, and I hope we can improve and get better and make Jones Intercable proud in Tampa Bay.
1994 celebrated the decade of public access in Tampa, and the VIPs rolled in.
Jeffrey, why don't you do the honors?
Solutions Special Edition.
I got to thank my beautiful wife, Barbara, for putting up with phone calls that we get 2 o'clock in the morning that sometimes call me out of the house to try and help somebody.
And I want to thank Lynn for being my mentor, and Dvorka for putting up with all my crazy antics.
And I'd like nothing better than one day to stand before the Hollywood establishment, winning an Oscar and saying I got my start at Jones Intercable Public Access. Thank you very much.
It's a special project to me, and I'm really excited that I got an award. So thank you very much.
Tom D is a consummate professional. This is obvious by the award that he's received and the work that he's done.
It's nice to see some of the mayor's staff here tonight presenting awards.
Make a very special presentation tonight to a very special guy, James Austin.
It's not quite a new van, but it's a good start. I don't know anybody who works harder than James.
Finally got one, huh?
And the one I really liked was Tropical Sweets.
The inscription on this clock we got for you. To Pam Webb, in appreciation of outstanding leadership.
I just couldn't let the 10th year go by without celebrating it with all those people who have made it what it is. And I hope that it continues, and I thank you very much.
And most importantly, the protection of our right to free thinking, free expression, and free speech. Jerry, it's been great. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
That was really great. It's great to see a lot of familiar faces still here. Give everybody a round of applause. I think that's great. Certainly an interesting stroll down the memory superhighway. Now, Christina, who's the presenter of our next category?
Before I introduce the next category, I'd like to say that the years have been kind to all of you, even and including.
I put on a little weight. My wife is in the audience. She said, when you lose hair up front, you're a lover. When you lose hair in the back, you're a thinker. And when you lose hair all over top, you think you're a lover. Thank you.
And thank God you have her, Dr. Duck. Our next category is educational programming, and our next guest presenter is the director of the Mass Communications Department at the University of South Florida, Dr. Dan Bagley.
The award for educational programming honors the presentation of information in a creative and interesting way that piques the interest of the viewers and holds their attention. The finalists are Centerfold, producer Julie Biscup; Dark Assumption, producer Glenn Pla; Spotlight Motorcycle Unit, producer Steve McClure. And the winner is Centerfold, producer Julie Biscup.
Oftentimes you'll see print media where you'll see cakes and desserts and everything on one page, and then exercising and a swimwear model on the next page. So you have a conflict right there with the person looking at those two pages and deciding which one should have more of an influence on themselves.
Pretty catchy title, huh? The program is about the media and eating disorders. And I used that title just to get people's attention, and it worked. So I'd like to thank Beth Dorsey, Laura Ackerman, Dr. Richard Bernstein, and Joel Provost for helping me shoot it. Thank you very much.
That's right, you go, girl. Except for, I think you've sold out, Julie. Look at you tonight, the height of beauty. I do want to say that on a special wine and cheese program, we featured Julie as the guest expert on the topic of women and eating disorders, and we featured the video, which she spent 4 months producing, and all in the name of healthy eating. Thank you, because that's very important for us females, right, ladies? Thanks again to Dr. Bagley, and congratulations to Julie Biscup.
Exactly. I eat a lot of hamburgers in 4 months, I'll tell you that. But ladies and gentlemen, I should point out that our next presenter is a real doctor. I just play one on TV. Our next category honors trailblazers in the television medium who, rather than follow the herd, prefer to cut their own path. Please welcome our next guest presenter. She's the great-great-great-great-grandniece of two brothers from Dayton, Ohio, who invented the medium which bears their name. I'm talking, of course, about Wilbur and Orville Television. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a direct descendant of the guys who started it all, Blanche Television herself.
Thank you, Dr. Christine, and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. The correct pronunciation of my name is Blank Television.
Blank.
Thank you. You know, a last name like mine, is both a blessing and a burden. When my two great-great-great-great-great funny uncles invented that medium less than a century ago, no one, well, maybe a few could have dreamed how far-reaching the benefits and the side effects would be. The television medium is arguably godlike. It giveth and it taketh away. And then it gives some more. It gives us pictures to look at, which of course destroyed teenage literacy, but that's a small price to pay. Indeed, for hundreds of channels that feature the best sitcoms, game shows, infomercials, and comedy specials our cultural elite broadcast professionals can dream up. As one of the Marx Brothers noted, television is the opiate of the masses, whose street value is equal to that of pop culture itself. The award for Best Innovative Programming honors the efforts of the producer who dares to boldly kick creative behind where it has never been kicked before. The finalists for Best Innovative Programming are Dark Assumption, producer Glenn Pla. Happy Halloween, producer Joel Provost. Soundbite Theater, producer Brinson M. Harris. And the winner is... Thank you. Soundbite Theater, producer Brinson M. Harris.
To the dictatorship of the proletariat.
Precisely, my boy.
Then, just how are we going to fix Mr. Malinoff's TV set?
You aren't. I want you to promise me never, never, never monkey around with the back of a TV set. That's a job for experts only. It's very dangerous, and you could get badly...
True words are never spoken. Now, people ask me what soundbite theater means, and when they ask me that, I just tell them that the TV set is the wrong place to look for meaning. Really, it's just a collection of clips that, when taken together, say something, I'm not really sure what, but it says something about pop culture. And of all the awards that I won tonight, this one means the most to me because I've always admired people that, rather than follow and do what others have done, do something original, and this says that Soundbite Theater is original. Thank you very much. This came late, by the way, but my name is in it, I promise. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brinson.
There could be some sort of conspiracy about that, Brinson. I would like to check that envelope later. Thank you.
That is if my check arrives sooner than later in the mail. But I did want to say, Brinson, congratulations. All the times we saw you carrying, you know, those flight attendants have those carts they carry their luggage on. That's what he has for all the tapes he brings in, which he files through to find all the wonderful things we see on Soundbite Theater. And I don't know about anybody else, but it is very original, and that's why I like you. No other reason, but that's why. Oh, sweet. Oh, speaking of that... That's a joke. Thank you. Our next category is music video, and our next guest presenter is a giant in the recording industry. A producer of both music and music videos, his work is well known to brain-dead teeny boppers languishing in front of TV sets across this great nation. Please welcome Morty Abner Kravitz.
Thank you. How you doing? How you doing, Doctor? Hey, Christina. Who loves you, baby?
Oh, baby.
You know, when these folks asked me to present this award, I didn't just leap at the chance. I bounced off the ceiling like the proverbial frog on a triple espresso. After seeing what I'm seeing here, these finalists really got it. They got it. And I don't care if they wanted to get rid of it. They're stuck with it. Pronoun reference, you say? Hotness, heat, steamy type heat with heat waves. I'm telling you, these finalists are sizzling hot video music producers. First, let's talk about single programs. And our mucho caliente finalists are Illusions producer Jason Beistel.
He's a winner, that's right.
Hey. What happened?
Oh, man. Oh, baby. He's the winner, right?
He's the winner.
All right. Joey Redner Jr. was a random access producer, the other nominee.
Okay.
Thanks again. This was a fun show to make, and I don't know if anyone's seen it. It was consist of music videos that were lip-synced by some of my friends, and then we just edited all the clips together. I'd like to thank Joe Rodriguez, Maddie Soler, Arturo Torres, and Miss Shantae, and of course, Mom and Dad. Thanks.
Sorry about that, Mr. Redner. And now, for the hotter than hot music video series and the finalist are
Do you got a list?
Mind Warp producer Joel Provost. Virtual television producer Brinson M. Harris. And the winner is Ooh, that's hot.
I wish I was a
Mind Warp man, produced by Joel Post.
I'd fly you around the universe in far more exoplanets, way out in space together, conquers of the sky. My heart would be a fireball, a fireball. Every time I gaze into your starry eyes, it takes us past to Jupiter, and maybe very soon we cruise along the Milky Way and land.
Joel's out doing the production right now. He's in the truck, and so I'm accepting it for him. So let's give him a big round of applause. He also made the animated opening at the beginning and all the graphics you're seeing, so he's a real graphics kind of dude. So let's give him a big round of applause.
Thank you, Morty.
Yeah, I want to thank you, Morty. I love your albums. A lot of people remember Morty as an artist formerly known as Saul Abner Kravitz. Now he's Morty Abner Kravitz.
We'll do lunch. Hey, baby.
And bring some of that medication you've been taking, would you? Oh, by the way, romantic liaisons at public access, that can happen too. Joel, Julie, Julie, Joel, future, marriage, partners, lovers. No. Okay. Cut me off now.
You are a talk show host, aren't you?
Relationships. Our next category is performing arts programming, and please welcome our next guest presenters, Jones Intercable Public Access Manager, Catho Kempfe, and Jones Intercable Director of Programming, Bill Schricker.
The award for Best Performing Arts honors the producer who creatively documents an event such as drama, dance, or theater before a live audience.
Capturing a live artistic performance from several angles requires not only excellent teamwork, but also a forte for the aesthetics of camera work, switching, and directing. The finalists are...
An Evening with Terry Stokes, producer Mark Bowes. Greetings, producer Jim Moss. Voices, Visions, and Dreams, produced by Dario Giordanelli. Oh, and the winner is? Voices, Visions, and Dreams, produced by Dario Giordanelli.
I have a feeling Dario is out in the truck. I hope there's somebody here to accept for him. If Dario will permit me, I would like to accept this honor on his behalf and congratulate him for all his hard work at Public Access, and also to thank him for his hard work tonight. He should be here to take this award himself.
Thank you, Mr. Schricker and Ms. Kempfe. In case you're wondering, those are two of Jones Intercable's heavy hitters. If you come down, not necessarily a must that you should suck up to them or schmooze, but it might get you somewhere. I didn't say that. Congratulations once again to our winner, Doctor. Dr. Darling. Darling Doctor, where's your wife right now? Sorry. Who's our next guest presenter and to present Best Children's Singles and Series Programming?
Well, it's my pleasure. We have more than one, and they are both veterans of the public access cable waves. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Anita Skinner, producer and host of Personality Profile, and Georgette Reinhardt, producer and host of Montage Cable News.
Well, hi, everyone. It's going to snow tomorrow, so wear your... What is it that goes with snow?
Skis and skates.
And I got Burt Reynolds back there. I handcuffed him. He keeps looking at Julia. I don't know why.
Well, I've got Tommy Ellison back there.
How'd you do it? Well, stay away from Burt.
Not interested in Burt.
But otherwise, let's have a party.
Okay.
Okay, let's go.
All right. Public access allows concerned members of the community to produce programming for children without the merchandising that we find on network television. And so, Georgette, you get to announce this.
Okay, the award for the best children's single program goes to the producer who creates a program best suited to the imagination of the young viewing audience. The finalists are Detective Casey, producer Captain Bill Wade, Frogs in Space, producer Dennis Jackson, Storybound, producer Glenn Plow. Anita?
And the winner is Storybound by Glenn Plow.
I'm surprised I got that award after that clip with Jim Moss. I'd like to thank the kids for this. They're the ones that did this. Thank you.
Anita, isn't that Dr. Doug over there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Doug.
Hey, ladies.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, Christina. You know, she's my anchor.
Yes, I know. Yes, she was.
Even the wine and cheese.
Right. And let's announce the winners for the Best Children's in a Series program. And the winner is...
Anita.
Oh, the finalists are. Okay. That's your part.
She's partying already. I told you not to have that drink. Give it to me.
All right. Who are the finalists?
You want me to read? Okay. See, she had too much drink. Al's Brain Damage. Producer Al Alonzo III. Graham's Games. Producer Dennis Jackson. Anita?
Okay. And the winner is Graham's Games, produced by Dennis Jackson.
The different views on this. Whoa, what was that? We're gonna go see what that was.
Since Dennis is not here, I'll accept the award for him. He also has helped me on my program in the past, and he's a wonderful person. And I know that he thanks you all, too. He's busy with the CAC and the AMC and all those other C's.
Thank you, Anita. Thank you, Georgette. I do want to give a special thanks to Georgette. She is a legend at Public Access. She did give me my start, and she's very generous, helping people be on her news and information show. If you want to come down, I bet she'll give you a chance. Also, Georgette has a cult following out there, because they tell me all the time, who is that woman who does the weather? I love her. So thanks, Georgette, and thanks, Anita.
Congratulations once again to our winners. And now, next on the agenda is a category, Christina, that is near and dear to my heart and to yours as well, live and interactive programming.
That means our hearts, right?
Right.
Thank you, Dr. Doug. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our next guest presenter for the live and interactive category. He is the product of years of research and development at the Institute for research and analysis of the causes and effects in and of fine TV programming's cybernetic game show host division. He is a cybernetic android with wit, charm, and tousled good looks. far beyond those of any human TV personality, including Geraldo. Please give a warm, steamy welcome to the host of the game show of the future, Cyber Wheel of Jeopardy, Hal 10,000.
Christina, Doug, good to see you. But, ladies and gentlemen, it's even better to see you. And I mean that because you look fantastic. You look fantastic. Go ahead. Yes, indeed. And I can say that with all sincerity and honesty, that you look so good that if my apartment were big enough, I'd love to take you all back there with me and have hors d'oeuvres and cocktail. Let's hear it. Yes. No, but ladies and gentlemen, I just have to say that it is really, truly an honor to be here tonight at the Golden Cassette Awards. Yes, indeed. And I'll tell you that with a straight face, without any sarcasm or irony, that the pride that I feel up here tonight will not be matched, at least for the next few days. Thank you! Now first, let's continue on with the reason that we're here. Well, maybe the other reason we're here. Ladies and gentlemen, the finalists for live and interactive single program are the 1994 Golden Cassette Awards, producer Pam Webb. Hillsborough County General Elections, Legia Large. And Wine and Cheese, producer Tom Colbert. All right, are you ready?
Yeah.
And the winner is the 1994 Golden Cassette Awards, producer Pam Webb.
It's so important to remember how many community producers and how many crew people entertain and inform our viewers every day. So it's a privilege to be here to recognize their efforts tonight. One of the most evident virtues.
I want to thank all the people that participated last year, those presenters, everybody that showed up, everybody, all the finalists, everyone that, and most of you I see again this year helping us support public access and cheer on those people to continue their good work and their hard work. And my final thanks goes to the greatest crew in the universe. Thank you very much.
Very, very beautiful. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the live and interactive series category. The finalists are Montage Cable News, producer Georgette Reinhardt. Virtual Television, producer Brinson M. Harris. And the winner is Virtual Television, producer Brinson M. Harris.
Good evening, Virtual Television.
What are those things sticking out of your head?
Oh, those are my VTV intracranial telepathy implants, and these antennae allow me to transmit my thought waves directly over the broadcast frequency bands, obviating the need for microphones or audio technicians, and cutting down to near nil the spurious emissions associated with television productions.
Okay.
Clear enough?
Yeah.
Are you reading my thoughts fairly well then?
No.
Well, I'll have to think harder. You'll have to listen harder then, I guess. Virtual tell?
Well, that was a live and interactive version of Virtual Television. I'd like to thank, first of all, Joel Provost, because Joel helped me when I first did virtual television in 1993 as a tape show, and then when I approached him with the idea of going live, he helped me out a lot. The second live season, Joel ran out of the studios with his screaming, and he'd had enough, so Dan Pombier and Frankie Rosario stepped in and helped me bring the show out live. Once again, thanks to all the people that called into the show with wacky phone calls, and I hope everybody had fun watching it. It was fun to bring to you, so thank you very much. I didn't mean to do that, sorry. It still works.
Congratulations, Brinson, and Hal. Hal. Oh, Hal.
Yes?
Darling, do you think we could co-host together sometime?
Why, I'd just love to.
Baby.
You bring the wine and I've got the cheese.
Okay.
Excellent, excellent. I want to say the one thing Brinson did give me for hosting the first few episodes of virtual television was the satellite link-up that I am wearing right now that Dr. Mojo then wore later in other shows. But way to go, Brinson. It's not that he's the only show or the only access producer down there. You might think he's won a lot of awards tonight, which he has, and congratulations to him. But that's what hard work and perseverance pay off, and I think everybody's recognized the fine job he's done. Well, how about that? What's up? What's with our next category, Christina?
I'm temporarily blinded, but besides that, next, oh, congratulations, Brinson. I think this is a sweep, as they say. Next up is public service announcement or promo, and please welcome our guest presenters from the City of Tampa, Government Access Television, Mindy Snyder, and from Hillsborough County Government Access Television, Steve McClure.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. The producer of a public service announcement has the challenge of presenting information in a short but memorable and creative package.
The award for best public service announcement, or promo, honors the presentation of black and white factual information in a colorful style. This year's finalists for best PSA promo are Goldmine of Golden Cassettes, producer Mark Harris. Tampa City Council, Bill Queenan, producer, and Jason Fisel produced Public Access PSA.
And the award goes to Goldmine of Golden Cassettes, produced by Mark Harris.
One can of gold spray paint and one battered Access videotape, a golden cassette. To commemorate the 1994 Golden Cassette Awards, catch Channel 24's Gold Mine of Golden Cassettes. Relive the past glories of Public Access's proudest moments. The glitz, the glamour, the glitches.
Friends. Your mama.
Every day this week at 2 p.m., only on Jones and Her Cable, Channel 24.
It's a miracle anybody won anything.
Well, I never thought I'd see the view from up here. It's quite interesting and different than seeing the front of the stage and every nook and cranny of that all night. I'd like to thank Julie Biscup for, of course, staying behind me to make sure that PSA was edited for last year. It might not have been unless she had shown considerable effort in getting me motivated. So I'd like to thank her. Thanks again.
Thanks, Mark, and congratulations. Mark has steadily moved up the ladder at Public Access into the pinnacle of the schmoozery and hobnobbing, and that's another one you might want to keep your eye on in case, you know, you come down and, you know, you want to get somewhere. No politics there, trust me, none.
Speaking of schmoozing, Christina, what's next?
Well, Doctor, I don't know offhand, but a quick glance at the script reveals not only that our next category is ethnic programming, but that our next guest presenters are, well, you read the names.
I will not only read the names, but I'll do it with a smile. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jones and Her Cable Public Access Database Coordinator Cynthia Hudson and Public Access Producer Barbara Griffin.
B
before we begin this script, I would like to appeal to the county commissioners to please approve the fees so that the Free Voice can be put back into the county.
Good evening, everyone. Ethnic programming addresses specific characteristics and uniqueness of a particular culture or group.
The award for the Best Ethnic Honors Program Achievement in the reporting on one strand of the tapestry of cultures that make up this community.
The finalists are Actua Aladad Hispania, producer Lagia Large, New Estra Tampa, producer Margarita Gonzalez Lampui, Our Caribbean Community, Francis Joseph. And the winner is Actualidad Hispania, produced by Lagia Largui.
Amigos y bienvenidos nuevamente a este su programa Actualidad Hispana. En el día de hoy les traemos un programa sumamente interesante. Cada año miles de niños y adultos hispanos mueren de leucemia, anemia aplástica y otras enfermedades mortales de la sangre. Muchas de estas.
Lee asked me to say one thing in her behalf, and she gave me very quick instructions in Spanish. Gracias.
Mucho gusto.
Congratulations to our winners. Barbara Griffin has done a great job with her own series. She discusses many political issues that are relevant to the black community and the African-American community and the community at large, and has worked so hard. So hopefully, as a county producer, she'll be able to come back, Barbara. And thank you, Cynthia. Cynthia is public access resident, house mother, grandmother, sister, confidant, friend, you name it. She has her hand on the pulse of public access, and there couldn't be a nicer or more beautiful woman around. Let's give a hand to Cynthia.
The next category is Best Sports Coverage. And to introduce our finalists, let's welcome our next guest presenters. They've called play-by-play on every worthwhile sport, plus many others on the OmniSport Network. Please give a sporting welcome to Bill Blazer and Joe Headset, who join us live via satellite. Gentlemen.
Thanks, Doctor. My esteemed colleague and I are as thrilled as Quakers at a quilting meet to be able to introduce our finalists in this epic battle royal amongst worthy competitors. As members of the Brotherhood of the Cheap Blue Polyester Blazer Society, we are honored to be able to pay homage to excellence in sports coverage. Joe, can you ever recall in all your many years as an annoying Brent Musburger-esque talking head when the field has ever been so strong?
You know, Bill, I'm reminded of that beer commercial that interrupts sports broadcasts of all kinds with a pack of redneck fishing buddies swilling down brewskis by the campfire. It don't get no better than this. I mean the spills, the chills, the agony of Howard Cosell. It's a rich field indeed. You know, Bill, we could go on and prattle about obscure sports trivia and listen to our own hot air, but satellite time ain't cheap, and happy hour is approaching faster than Jesse Owens is outrunning future stormtroopers. So, let's go ahead and announce the finalists in sports coverage single program. They are
Ben's Adult Baseball League, producer Peggy Lenny.
Sportsman's Quest, producer Myra Forrester.
Wild Outdoors, producer Jim Story.
And the winner is...
Oh my gosh. Oh, Christina, what happened? I'm not really sure. We lost the transmission there.
This is a professional operation.
Yeah, we are Access producers. Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize. We seem to have lost the satellite feed. I'm really sorry.
This never happens.
No, it doesn't.
No, never.
Hold on, excuse me, sir. We're kind of in the middle of the awards presentation here.
Yeah, I know.
What's going on?
I'm the chief satellite engineer.
Uh-huh.
We got problems with the main reactor of the induction core Whitestone Bridge Oscillation Transformer Converter House.
Uh-huh,
it's a mess. Said,
I believe it has been, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And I'm really sorry, but it looks like our satellite's going to be out until we can get a sawtooth wave azimuth separator turbo overthruster linkage interrupter cable. And a couple of fuses, too.
Well, gee whiz, we're just about to announce a winner here. Could you help us out?
Oh.
I'm really embarrassed, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry.
Now, Dr. Doug, I just happen to have in my official electronics engineer coveralls a copy of the winner. And I wouldn't mind announcing it if that wouldn't blow your thunder.
I've got thunder to spare.
The best sports single program winner is Men's Adult Baseball League producer Peggy Lenny. Hey, Peggy! Where are you, babe? That's funny. You don't look like a Peggy.
Hi, I'm Nilo Menendez from Open for Your Leisure. And let me tell you, these guys aren't on strike. We have some baseball here in Tampa. This is the Men's Adult Baseball League of Tampa Bay. And we're here and we're going to be watching the ball game. So let's watch the ball game, catch some of this action.
I'm not Peggy Lenny, but she has put a lot of time into this particular sports broadcast. We have a men's over 35 baseball league that deserves a lot of credit, and so does she and the other people who work so hard to make this a success. Thank you very much.
You did a great job.
Thank you. Thank you. This is so much fun. Oh, good God. You know,
why don't you go ahead and announce the winners and the finalists for the sports series programming, would you please?
Oh, yes, I sure would. Okay. Geez. The finalists for sports series programming are on Focus on Sport, producer Shirley Gregory. I beg your pardon? Pro Wrestling Weekly, producers Shannon Rose and Darren Martin. And the winner is Pro Wrestling Weekly, produced by Shannon Rose and Darren Martin. Yay, yay, yay.
I just have a couple things to say. First off, I'd like to thank the many people, all the liaisons that have helped out with the production. Our crew, Judy and Earl Holly, the Alonzos, Al and Gail, Joe Vasquez, my good friend Shirley.
I'm proud of you, Shannon. I just wanted to come up and tell you that.
Chris, you know we're live.
Live?
Yes.
Oh, how's everybody doing out there? I just want to tell you, congratulations. I'm behind you, 100%.
Okay.
I like you, Shannon.
Thank you. Okay, well, that was crazy Chris Nelson, professional wrestler.
Okay, thank you, Chris. You can go take a seat. You're presenting with me later.
Okay. Well, I'd also like to thank Shirley Cruz, Paul Spiegel, Earl Lunsford, Mark Harris, Richard George, my co-producer, Darren Martin. I'd also like to thank the many people who have been supportive, my mom and dad, the wrestlers, Pat Packham, and Jerry Ledbetter, Julie Biscup, and to a person that means so much to me and who has not only changed my life, but somebody that I care about and love a lot. That's my fiance, Amy. Thank you once again.
Okay, see you next year.
Well, let's hope there are no more further glitches. Thanks a lot there. We appreciate your help.
Anytime.
All right. We will.
I think those overalls would look good on James Austin, the real big cheese, so to speak, at Public Access. And congratulations to Peggy, who won in a category typically dominated by male producers of male sports programming, not that I'm a feminist or anything close to it, but congratulations. And Shannon, would you like to be on the show sometime? Your fiance, you know, we could talk about relationships.
All right.
Actually, yes.
Thank you, Christina. Next up, documentary programming. And please, we were going to try and wrap this up pretty soon. Welcome our next presenter. Dave Olive is now an independent producer with his own production company, but he was the Public Access first manager and my friend. Please welcome Dave Olive.
It's been about 13 years since I rolled into town and 12 years since we opened the doors to the Public Access Center. This is the 10th year of our awards ceremony, and it's very exciting to watch all the programmers and the programs develop into better quality programmers and programming over that time period. The category of Best Documentary honors a production of informative and interesting programming that is designed to enlighten and inspire. All of the individuals working in this category deserve praise and encouragement for their work, and I'm honored to present this year's finalists in the documentary category. The finalists are Artists Unlimited, producer Pam Webb, Buffalo Soldiers, producer Cornelia Washington, and Centerfold, producer Julie Biscup. And they all deserve praise. But there's one winner. And that winner is my friend Pam Webb with Artists Unlimited. Probably working on a production someplace.
Stepped into a wonderful situation because we're two blocks north of where they're building the aquarium. The city had already scheduled a feasibility study for the whole area. They had done an urban plan.
You know, if I'd known this, I might have dressed up for you guys. I'd like to thank Dario Giordinelli, because he was my partner in crime on this, and we'd spent hours and hours and months on a project that I thought was going to take a few days. So thank you very much, everyone. And congratulations to all the finalists and winners tonight. Thank you.